Good day, everyone. My name is Pastor Eke Chukwuchinedum, and I'm your host at Everyday Prayer Guide Television. Today, we shall be looking at deliverance prayers, breaking the curse of barrenness. We shall be looking at deliverance prayers, and we shall be focusing on breaking the curse of barrenness. I trust God that by the end of this video, everything that has caused barrenness in your life, every satanic force or satanic curse or demonic utterance that have led to barrenness in your life, in your body, in your the fruit of your labor, they shall be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. I want you to be strong in faith. There is nothing that God cannot do. There is nothing that He has not done. There is no fruitful, there is no barrenness issue that is too big for God to handle. I don't care what is the cause of your own barrenness. I don't care if it is man-made or if it is natural. But whatever it is, barrenness is never the portion of every child of God. As a matter of fact, barrenness is a curse. And that curse shall be broken in your life today in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. That curse of barrenness, in your life that have made people mock you, it shall be broken in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I want you to participate with me in this video. Let us pray together. Let us join forces together. The Bible says, when two or three are gathered, He's in our midst. God is here because you and I are here. All of you watching this video, we are all watching together and we are praying together. God is with us. Every spell, every enchantment from any satanic coven that have held your children from coming forth, they shall be scattered in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Now, before we go into the prayers, I want to encourage you. If your goal is to build your prayer life, if you want to build your spiritual life, if you want to be on fire for God, I encourage you to subscribe to this channel. I encourage you to be part of us, because when your prayer life is on fire, the devil cannot manipulate your destiny. A lot of people go to deliverance and they are delivered, but after a while, the demons come back. Why? Because when the demon check them again, he find out that their prayer life is not on fire. And that is the goal that this channel is going to fulfill. It's going to make sure that your prayer life is on fire. Every day, we release powerful prayer videos that can change your story forever. So I encourage you to subscribe. Hit the subscribe button. Be part of what God is doing in this channel. And the Lord will bless you richly in the name of Jesus. Subscribe now. And thank you very much for subscribing in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, breaking the curse of barrenness. God's number one desire for His children is to be fruitful. When God created man and woman, Adam and Eve, he blessed them. The first thing he said, be what? Fruitful. And what? Multiply. Be what? Fruitful. And be what? Multiply. And He said in Exodus chapter 23 from verse 25 to 26, in fact in verse 26, He said, none shall cast their young or be barren in the land. He was talking about His children. In verse 25, He said, and ye shall serve the Lord thy God, and He shall bless your bread and water, He shall take away sickness from you. In verse 26, He said, none shall cast their young. In other words, none of my children shall miscarry or be barren in the land. Barrenness is a curse. That is why when Micah, the wife of David, the daughter of Saul, mocked David when David was dancing to the Lord, God blocked her womb. When King Abimelech and when Pharaoh tried to take the wife of Abraham from Abraham, Sarah, God blocked their womb. He blocked the womb of the family people. It is a curse. It is what? It is a curse. If anything that will not make you produce is a curse. And are you hearing me? And listen to me. There is nobody in the Bible that had issue with barrenness that didn't have a child except for Micah. And it was because God was the one that shot her womb. So she never had a child. But every other person, from Sarah to Hannah to the women in the house of Pharaoh, to everyone believing God for children, they all had children, including Elizabeth. They all had children. Why? Because God is not the one behind your barrenness. God is not the one behind. The purpose of these are prayers today. We are focusing on those whose barrenness has a spiritual undertone. What do I mean by that? Your barrenness is as a result of diabolic means, diabolic activities. Your barrenness is because a witch somewhere or a wizard somewhere have done something to withhold your children. Your barrenness is as a result of spirit husband, spirit wife. Your barrenness is as a result of foundational problems, evil patterns. Your mother suffered from barrenness. Your grandmother suffered. Your great-grandmother suffered like that. It has been in the lineage. And now, you are now facing the same thing. You are now facing the same thing. So, not all barrenness are spiritual. Many of them are natural causes. Natural causes, they can be handled medically. But I'm talking about those who have checked themselves medically. And they have checked and found out that they are okay, but for some strange reasons, they are not having children. Or who the devil has afflicted with one kind of disease or the other that is not going. They have taken medications after medication, they have gone for scan, they have done all manner, and yet the devil or the demon keeps oppressing them. They are not still free. They are still not free. Today, we shall be engaging in prayers that will scatter the hold of barrenness in your life in the name of Jesus. God has said it. Whenever God speaks, he means it. He said, none of my children shall be barren in the land. None of my children shall be barren in the land. I want you to open your heart as we pray these prayers today. God is set to change your story forever. I have had testimonies of many people who God has delivered from the shackles of barrenness. People who have been mocked and laughed at. But the God of heaven showed up in that situation and scattered the plague of barrenness in their life. He scattered. Listen to me. Anna broke the seal of barrenness on the altar of prayer. The Bible says she went and she was traveling. She was praying. She was praying until Eli came and said, woman, are you drunk? It's very early in the morning. And she said, no, I'm not drunk. I'm a woman of a sorrowful heart. And I'm pouring my heart to God. And he said, go that way. Your request has been granted. God showed up on the altar of prayer. So I encourage you, pray this prayer with every energy you have got. Pray it with passion. Because the God of heaven is set to deliver you from that barrenness in the name of Jesus. The God that did it for Sarah. The God that did it for Anna. The God that did it for Elizabeth. And her husband. That same God will do it for you today in the name of Jesus. Mark today, 9 months from today, you shall hear cries of children in your house in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, let's go to the prayer proper. Breaking the curse of barrenness. Let's begin to appreciate the Lord this moment. Let's begin to appreciate Him. Let's start with giving Him thanks. Psalm 92 verse 1. Say, it is a good thing to give thanks to the Lord. Give Him thanks. Give Him praise. Appreciate Him. He's a good God. He's a good God. Give Him thanks. Give Him praise. Father, we give You praise. Jesus, we adore You. Take all the glory. Take all the honor. Take all adoration. Blessed be Your holy name. Blessed be Your holy name. Blessed be Your holy name. Father, we thank You. Blessed be Your holy name. In Jesus' name, we are praying. Amen. In Jesus' name, we are praying. Amen. Now we are beginning with the prayers. We are taking the first prayer now. This first prayer, we are addressing evil altars. Evil altars. Evil altars are satanic altars where the fate of innocent people are decided for evil, for negatively. Where they ruin destinies. They raise evil altars where they worship their own deities and they make utterances to frustrate you. They may say, as I sacrifice this in this altar, this woman will never have children. As I sacrifice this in this altar, this family, nobody will ever amount to anything. As I sacrifice this, that these are evil altars where evil utterances are made. Are you hearing me? Now, we're going to be addressing those evil altars now. Are we set? We're going to be saying, I command. Pray with me that prayer now. I command every evil altar speaking against my fruitfulness to crash by fire now in the name of Jesus. Now you're going to be commanding that evil altar speaking against your fruitfulness to crash by fire now in the name of Jesus. Are you set to pray that prayer? Lift up your voice and pray that prayer. I command every evil altar speaking against my fruitfulness to crash by fire now in the name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and pray that prayer. I command every evil altar speaking against my fruitfulness. I command you to crash by fire now, in the name of Jesus. Every evil altar speaking against my fruitfulness, crash by fire, crash by fire. Prayer, prayer, crash by fire. Every evil altar speaking against my fruitfulness, I command you to crash by fire. I command you to crash by fire. I command you to crash by fire. In the name of Jesus, every evil altar speaking against my fruitfulness, I command you now, crash by fire. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Prayer two. Prayer two. In this prayer two, we're going to be addressing satanic powers fighting against our fruitfulness. Satanic powers fighting against our fruitfulness. Pray this prayer. Now say, I take authority. I take authority over all satanic powers fighting against my fruitfulness in the name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and pray that prayer. I take authority over every satanic powers fighting against my fruitfulness. I take authority over every satanic powers fighting my fruitfulness in the name of Jesus. I take authority over every satanic powers fighting my fruitfulness. I take authority over every satanic powers fighting my fruitfulness in the name of Jesus. I take authority over every satanic powers fighting my fruitfulness in the name of Jesus. I take authority over every satanic powers fighting my fruitfulness in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Prayer three. Father, cancel the evil pronouncement against my fruitfulness in Jesus' name. Every evil utterance against my fruitfulness, every evil pronouncement against my fruitfulness, I cancel them now. In the name of Jesus, I cancel them now. Begin to cancel them. Every evil tongue, every evil pronouncement against your fruitfulness, begin to cancel them now. Begin to cancel them now. Regote prega daskate. Every evil pronouncement against your fruitfulness, begin to cancel them. Begin to cancel them now. Begin to cancel them now. Begin to cancel them. Every evil pronouncement against your fruitfulness, begin to cancel them now. Every evil utterance against your fruitfulness, begin to cancel them now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Prayer four. I take authority over all curses emanating from breaking the vows made by my ancestors that is now affecting my fruitfulness in the name of Jesus. Now, let me explain this. Now, your ancestors before several centuries before you were born were worshiping idols. And they have seeded their children and yet children yet unborn to those idols. And because many years have passed, your ancestors have died and your fathers and grandfathers no longer worship those idols again. Now they have reneged, they have broken the vow they made to those ancestral spirits. And now those ancestral spirits are now attacking the future generation. Now, they can also be attacking you in the area of fruitfulness. Because why? They are not being served again, so now they are reacting. That is what is called ancestral powers fighting your destiny, foundational spirit fighting your destiny. So we are going to be separating ourselves by fire now in the mighty name of Jesus. That's what this prayer is talking about now. We are going to be saying, I take authority, prayer four. I take authority over all the curses emanating from breaking the vows made by my ancestors that is now affecting my fruitfulness. I take authority over those forces now. In the name of Jesus, lift up your voice and say, I take authority over all curses emanating from breaking the vows made by my ancestors that is now affecting my fruitfulness. I take authority over those curses and I declare them null and void. In the name of Jesus, I declare those curses null and void. In the name of Jesus, every curse generated from the breaking of the vow my ancestors made with their deities, I take authority over those curses. And I say, I declare them null and void. I declare them null and void. They have no effect over my fruitfulness anymore. I command those curses to lose their hold from my fruitfulness. In the mighty name of Jesus, lose your hold from my fruitfulness. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Prayer five. I command all demons associated with any broken evil parental vow and dedication to depart from me now. In the name of Jesus, I command every demon associated with the breaking of my parental vow with their deities, with their idols, I command those powers to be destroyed now. In the name of Jesus, lift up your voice and say, I command all demons associated with any broken parental vow and dedication. I command those demons to depart from me now. I command those devils to depart from me now. Every devil that have been associated with the breaking of the vow that my ancestors made, I command those devils separated from me now, out of my life, out of my destiny, out of my life, out of my destiny, out of my life, out of my destiny, in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Are you praying a prayer? Prayer 6. Oh God, I separate myself from the sins of my forefathers by the precious blood of Jesus. Lift up your voice and pray that prayer. Oh Lord, I separate myself from the sins of my forefathers. Pray that prayer, pray that prayer, pray that prayer. Oh Lord, I separate myself by fire from the sins of my ancestors, my forefathers. In the mighty name of Jesus, I separate myself by the blood of Jesus. I separate myself by the blood of Jesus from the sins of my forefathers. I separate myself by the blood of Jesus from my sins of my forefathers. I separate myself. I separate myself by the blood of Jesus from the sins of my forefathers. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Prayer 7. I separate myself from every curse from my father's compound, in the name of Jesus. Begin to pray that prayer. I separate myself from every curse from my father's compound. Begin to separate yourself. I separate myself, oh Lord, from every curse from my father's compound, in the name of Jesus. I separate myself from every curse from my father's compound, in the mighty name of Jesus. I separate myself from every curse from my father's compound. I separate myself. I separate myself from every curse from my father's compound. Rebatos yakatelo. I separate myself, oh Lord, from every curse from my father's compound, in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Now, prayer 8. I command the curse of barrenness to be broken in my life, in the name of God. Begin to command the curse of barrenness right now. I command the curse of barrenness to be broken in my life, in the mighty name of Jesus. I command the curse of barrenness to be broken in my life. I command the curse of barrenness to be broken in my life, in the name of Jesus. I command the curse of barrenness to be broken in my life. I command the curse of barrenness to be broken in my life. I command the curse of barrenness to be broken. Be broken. Be broken in my life. Be broken in my life, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. By the anointing, prayer 9, of the Holy Spirit upon my life, I break every yoke of the curse of barrenness in my family, in the name of Jesus. By the anointing of the Holy Spirit, I break every yoke of the curse of barrenness in my family. Lift up your voice and begin to pray for yourself and your family. By the anointing of the Holy Ghost, I break every curse of barrenness in my family, in the name of Jesus. By the anointing of the Holy Spirit, I break every curse of barrenness in my family. By the anointing of the Holy Ghost, I break every curse of barrenness in my family. By the anointing of the Holy Spirit, I break every curse of barrenness in my life, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Prayer 10. I command any demon afflicting my womb or causing miscarriage in my life, I command that devil to leave me now, in the name of Jesus. You satanic force causing me miscarriage in my womb, I command you to get out of my life forever, in the name of Jesus. I cast you out. You satanic power afflicting my womb or causing miscarriages, I scatter you by fire. I command you to pack your load now and go, in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to declare your fruitfulness. I decree that I am fruitful. The curse of barrenness is broken in my life. The curse of barrenness is broken in my life. I am free. I am fruitful. I am set free forever, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I thank you. Give him thanks, give him praise. Father, I bless your holy name. Blessed be your holy name. Take all the glory forever. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are free. You are free forever, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Now, if you want to get the full prayer program, this full prayer program, maybe because we are praying too fast for you, or the prayers are not, we didn't take all the prayers, you can get them at the below this video, the description section of this video. You see all the prayers and the link to get more of these prayers, and it will bless you richly, in the mighty name of Jesus. If you have been blessed by this video, I encourage you to like this video, to share it with your friends in social media, spread the gospel, and also subscribe to this video so that you can be blessed more and more by our future videos, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. So like this video, comment on this video, let us know how you are blessed, and let us know the things we'll pray for, we'll pray about. If you have prayer topics, you can share it with us at this comment section, and we'll pray them as soon as we get them, in the mighty name of Jesus. I still remain Pastor Ekechukwu Chinedum, your host at everydayprayerguide.com. Remain blessed, stay safe, in Jesus' name. Amen. You are fruitful forever, in Jesus' name. Amen.